What TV show did you lose interest in and at what point did you stop watching? Fairly Odd Parents. It went so downhill after they introduced Poof. His birth episode was fine, but the others after it? No thanks. Nowadays, they have this super annoying little girl that Timmy apparently has to share his fairies with, and she's not even a miserable kid. She's super popular, super successful, and even Mr. Crocker loved her enough to not hunt Timmy's fairies for a bit. Not to mention, I hear they changed Crocker's backstory too. He went from that tragic kid who Timmy caused to lose his fairies to some butthole who abused them. Glee. After the original class graduated high school, the show couldn't make sense anymore. The alumni couldn't just hang out at their old high school. That would be weird and unhealthy. Once upon a time, I started to get bored with it around season 3, but stuck it out midway through season 4 mainly because I had been so in love with the first season and felt loyalty to it. I don't know, but it seemed like it was less of a show and more of a what Disney story can we do to death this season. I felt like the Peter Pan thing was such a waste of a storyline and could have been done so much better. After that I just kind of gave up with it, I think. It has devolved into fan fiction. Maybe it always was, but they dressed it up better in the first season. Weeds was another one. I watched it on Netflix, really liked the first maybe 3 seasons. Then suddenly it seemed to have jumped the shark and got too ridiculous. The show should have ended when Nancy burned a grass stick to the ground. Everything after that was like a completely different show. True Blood. At first I loved it, but with each season it was like, how much more can we fit into this story universe? I don't recall the exact spot I stopped watching, but it became too much to keep track of and I lost interest. At one point Sucky finds out she's an alien fairy or something, that's when I stopped. Prison Break. Lost all interest after they escaped from a prison for the 3rd or 4th time. The last season is beyond awful, you had a lucky escape. Arrow. At the point where I realized they were just going to keep upping the ante and suspense and how ridiculous the villains were, and when I realized the dialogue sucked. Once Daredevil came out I could no longer put up with how cheesy Arrow is. Revolution. It was an amazing idea for a show, but they got too much into the technology aspect and ruined the show. I was really disappointed. It had the potential to be amazing. Yes, I loved the It's Modern Times, but really 1860 vibe. I honestly didn't mind the pendant things that temporarily power stuff, but then they go to the tower and all of a sudden are fighting with energy weapons and launching nukes. Does anyone know why Two Broke Girls is still on? Boobs. Supernatural after season 5. This TV show should have ended on that season. I'm gonna get crucified for this one, but I stopped watching Orange is the New Black towards the end of the first season. The main character was just uninteresting to me and was slowly becoming a scumbag. The main character has gotten worse and worse, but she's also gotten less and less screen time. The last 2 seasons haven't been bad, but they've had some crappy episodes. The best ones tend to be the backstories on the side characters. You can hate one character one episode, but then by the end of the next you'll completely sympathize with them. Heroes Season 2, when Hayden Panettiere purposefully clipped her toe off with a nail clipper. As soon as I saw that, I turned off the TV then went back to my homework. Oh man, so many problems with Heroes. Like the guy forgetting he had super hearing, even though he stole the powers of a person who had a perfect memory. American Horror Story Season 4 did me in. Season 1 was great, Season 2 was weaker and lacking in a clear direction but still okay, and Season 3, while weak, at least had a somewhat cohesive storyline. But Season 4, as soon as they started in with singing songs from the wrong decades and treating it like a dark and gritty Glee, I said frick this noise. Sons of Anarchy. They really jumped the shark with that whole abduction to N. Island thing. Death Note. When L died, I stopped caring. Spoiler. You didn't miss much. After that point it just wasn't nearly as good. The guy who replaced L was awful. HBO's Girls started off really strong, but around the middle end of the 3rd season, most of the characters became parodies of themselves and really unrelatable. Lena Dunham's character in particular became completely insufferable. Lena Dunham is just being true to herself by being insufferable. Breaking Bad. Somewhere in season 5 my dad died. I always watched it with him. Couldn't bring myself to finish the show. Still can't start Better Call Saul. Dang dude. Sorry about your loss. I bet your dad would want you to finish it. Nothing wrong with remembering good times with him. All the best. I watched Grey's Anatomy for 9 seasons. I got pee off when the cute older doctor died. Mark something. Can't remember his last name. I hit the last straw after their most recent disaster. If it's not a bomb inside of a person, a live shooter, a plane crash, or a drowning, it's something else as equally as far-fetched that the main character has to endure. In the real world, she would be holed up inside of an insane asylum. It just got so overdone. Suits. I binge watched it but had to stop because I felt the drama was too obviously fabricated. Oh, they just solved this big thing that we were all waiting for? You wanna enjoy the happiness? Well, frick you. Here's some unnecessary romantic drama. House. Great show, but every episode is the same. I tried rewatching it last year and still could get to the last season. That's what makes it great. You see 4 episodes and you basically have seen them all. Homeland. Between the awful, plot hole riddled season 3 and season 4's infuriating season finale, I just stopped caring. They really should have gone through with the ending of the first season, then it would have been absolutely awesome. Sons of Anarchy, season 3, when they went to Belfast and the theme tune started being played on a banjo. God, that sounded dreadful. I watched the whole series. But I am not gonna lie, the writers only know how to do one style. Everyone lies and everyone dies. I watched one episode of Mad Men and really enjoyed it. Haven't gone back since. One of my favorite shows ever. The most character development of any show. Like Breaking Bad has 2 characters that are fully developed. Mad Men has maybe 10. Of course that means there is sparse action. This show is very very in the drama genre. Basically seasons 8 and 9 of The X-Files. I ended up just watching a few episodes here and there. Some good stuff, mostly bad. And it's not Doggett's fault. He's a good character. In fact, he would have been awesome to see in the latest season. Doggett's character forced Scully into the role of the believer, which was a cool dynamic for the show. And it's hard to hate the character because he was just so earnest. But the lack of Mulder, the lack of character development for Rise, a strong focus on cult psychic episodes and the confusing super soldier plot made those 2 seasons the weakest by far. Big Bang Theory. Loved it when it was a bunch of guys nerding out, then it changed into a bad soap opera. Agreed, they turned it into a crappy Friends ripoff. The Walking Dead, around the time when they get to that farm. Season 2 I think. Carl is such a stupid frick. Once Upon a Time. The curse was lifted, and then I felt like it started dragging out. I don't know how it's still going, to be honest. The whole point was the curse making people not know who they really were, and that was lifted after what? Season 2? Smallville. They took themselves way too seriously, and the acting was weird. Game of Thrones after season 5 because I have to wait for more Game of Thrones to come out before I start watching again. Family Guy for me. First 3 seasons before it initially got cancelled were incredible. I was so disappointed it got cancelled. Then it came back and I was really excited. First season back wasn't as good but it was still really good. Then the next season was okay. Then the rest was just terrible. I actually started using it as a sleeping aid in season 6 because I just found it so unfunny and boring. It insists upon itself. Though I have become less interested in The Walking Dead over the years, I still watch it continuously. So I figured I'd watch the spin-off Fear the Walking Dead. That show was absolute crap. The characters are all unlikable and poorly written. The acting ranges from okay to embarrassingly bad. And the overall show is just boring. Heroes. During the writer's strike, went real dull real fast. The Vampire Diaries. Stopped after season 4. I still watch it and it's terrible. I can't seem to give it up yet, though. Last Man on Earth. After they added more people every episode, I was so confused on what the title of the show was about. As soon as January Jones showed up, the main guy was completely unlikable. Like a switch, he became a parody of men. Doctor Who. I thought the show started dropping in quality towards the end of the 5th season. The sixth season wasn't that great, the seventh was awful, and I didn't even finish the eighth or bother with the ninth. Though I really like Peter Capaldi's Doctor, I don't know what's happened to it, but it went from a fun and enjoyable show to something not fun and enjoyable. It just isn't as good as it was earlier on. Criminal Minds. I was pretty obsessed with it, so got quite far through, but I gave up when there was an episode with a guy who became a murderer because he couldn't feel pain and so didn't develop empathy. That was just too far-fetched for me. Dexter. I hung on much longer than most Redditors, but when Deb was in love with Dexter, I just had to cut my losses and realize the show was over. But then I heard about how they ended it. I went back and finished the last two episodes and just lost it when I saw Dexter as a freaking lumberjack. I mean, really? Just leave Hannah and your son? Total idiocy. I remember it was so bad by the end that the week before the finale, we didn't have an episode thread. Our Dexter instead dedicated that night's thread to Breaking Bad's Ozymandias, which had aired at the same time. Shows how bad a show got that even the place where its vocal positive minority was turned on it. House of Cards. I watched the first two seasons and was absolutely riveted. By the beginning of the third season, it had just gotten to be too much and a little cookie cutter. Frank does something shady. Someone knows. Frank manipulates them to his advantage. That person is no longer needed. Frank kills them. Spoiler. I just couldn't take it anymore. Season 4 is surprisingly good. I haven't finished it yet, but it seems like the best season thus far. I really recommend you continue. You're all really gonna make me say it, aren't you? I can pinpoint the exact moment I stopped watching The Simpsons. The 15th of December, 2002. The Great Louse Detective. The moment it was revealed that Homer's attempted murderer was the son of Frank Grimes. I literally yelled out frick this and changed the channel. I haven't seen a single new episode since. I lost interest in Cheers when Diane left the show. I've only seen a few episodes after her departure. It just wasn't the same to me without the Sam and Diane chemistry. I hope I'm not showing my age too much. I am old enough to remember when Cheers was still on TV, but it wasn't till I was in grad school that I bought the DVDs for nostalgia's sake and binge-watched them. Sons of Anarchy. I think I stopped watching shortly after season 4. I just got tired of the same back and forth. Jax wants to get out of guns, but oh wait, first he has to get into drugs to get out of guns. Jax loves his mom and hates Tara, then he loves Tara and hates his mom. It was all so stupid and repetitive. I basically just read the synopsis and how it all ended and was like, yup, saw that bull's coming. My so watched it all through and I would catch glimpses. I'm glad I stopped watching cause it just got way too violent. The school shooting, Tig's daughter, the large amount of debauchery. At the end, there were literally no characters that I liked anymore. Turn. They made a 300 reference in a period drama. Immediately stopped watching. You have been visited by the happy baby pygmy murder cow. Back away slowly and subscribe quickly to ensure your safety. Thanks for watching. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Or don't. Either way, have a great day, you magnificent people.